if we look back at what we know about atomic orbitals and combine that with what we know about molecular shapes, a couple of things stand out. The first one is, we know that the p orbitals, px, py, and pz, are all orthogonal to each other. That is, they're perpendicular to each other. They have an angle of 90 degrees between them. And the px is 90 degrees to the py, which is 90 degrees to the pz. So the x, y, and z directions. One of the things that's interesting is in a molecule that has four bonds, such as methane, you can see it here, the bond angles between the hydrogen atom are 109.5, which is not 90 degrees. And so this is interesting because if the bonds are being made by the overlaps of orbitals on the hydrogen atoms with orbitals from the carbon atom, then why are the bond angles not 90 degrees? Why are they 109.5 degrees? One explanation for this phenomenon is called hybridization. It is the mathematical mixing of p orbitals with an s orbital. And so we mix these things together in a fashion that's going to give us four identical orbitals. So when the s orbital mixes with the p orbitals, we get a total of four new hybrid orbitals. These new orbitals are called SP3 hybrid orbitals. And the shape of these hybrid orbitals is different than either the S or the P. And so what we get with these is we get a large lobe and a little tiny nub. And so this is called a SP3 hybrid orbital. When we look at the energy of these new orbitals, we know that the p orbitals are higher in energy than the s orbitals. So these are the p orbitals up here, and the s orbitals would have an energy that is slightly lower. And when they come together to form the sp3 hybrid orbitals, the energy of those four orbitals is going to be in between the p and the s orbitals from which they were produced. Generally speaking, bonding is thought to be the overlap of orbitals of one atom with orbitals of another atom. So in the case of methane, we have four hydrogen atoms, and those hydrogen atoms we know have electrons in the 1s orbital. And the carbon atom is going to use its two sp3 hybrid orbitals in order to form overlapping areas with the s orbitals from the hydrogen atom. So that overlap is going to look something like this. So there is an sp3 hybrid orbital, and here is an s orbital from the hydrogen atom. And so this overlapping area here in the middle is going to be where the electrons are going to be residing. And so that is going to form a bond between the carbon and the hydrogen. Having these four sp3 hybrid orbitals allows the molecule to have a bond angle between the hydrogen and the carbon and the hydrogen atom of 109.5 degrees. The bond angles are not constrained to 90 degrees like they would be with p, x, p, y, p, z orbitals. When one of the s orbitals and two of the p orbitals combine to hybridize, we get what are known as SP2 hybrid orbitals. And SP2 hybrid orbitals have the same shape as SP3 hybrid orbitals. So they have a large lobe and a small nub. But there's only three of them produced. And so that leaves, once the hybridization has taken place, we get 1, 2, 3. These are SP2 hybrid orbitals. And we also have a remaining P orbital that is unhybridized. The P orbital that is unhybridized has the same dumbbell shape as a classic P orbital. As we've seen in the past, the hybridized SP2 hybrid orbitals are going to want to form a trio of orbitals that are as far away from each other as possible. In order to do this, the best possible arrangement is to form 120 degree angles. In other words, these are the orbitals that are used when molecules form that have 120 degree bond angles. So these are going to be the orbitals that are used when molecules form that have trigonal pyramidal geometry. What is the role of the SP2 hybrid orbitals and the unhybridized P orbital in bonding? The SP2 hybrid orbitals are in a plane, hence the trigonal pyramidal geometry. The electrons that are used in the bonding during the overlap of the SP hybrid orbitals, or SP2 or SP3 hybrid orbitals, those electrons that you see here are known as sigma electrons or sigma bonds. There are electrons in the P orbitals, and those electrons from the P orbitals can overlap as well. And the electrons from the P orbitals form another bond known as a pi bond. So this is the overlap that is responsible for a double bond, or, as we'll see in a minute, a triple bond. One of the two lines that we draw for a double bond is going to be for a sigma bond. The other one is going to be for a pi bond. Because the SP2 hybrid orbitals are used for bonding situations where we have trigonal planar geometry, anytime we have trigonal planar geometry, we would call that carbon or oxygen or nitrogen or whatever the atom is, we would call that SP2 hybridized. In the case where we have one of the P orbitals overlapping with one of the S orbitals, we get a situation that is known as SP hybridization. In SP hybridization, two of these orbitals will hybridize, forming two SP hybrids, and there will be two unhybridized P orbitals remaining. In this situation, the SP hybrid orbitals will want to get as far away from each other as they can, and so they form directly across from each other, and they are responsible for what we know of as linear geometry. The two unhybridized P orbitals can overlap with another set of unhybridized P orbitals on an adjacent atom and can form not one, but two pi bonds. And so this is the kind of bonding that you get when you have a carbon or a nitrogen that is triple bonded to another atom. And the geometry that goes along with this is linear. And so we would say that this carbon atom right here and this nitrogen atom right here, we would say that these are SP hybridized. To sum up hybridization, an atom is SP3 hybridized if it is tetrahedral. And we know that tetrahedral molecules are going to have all sigma bonds. An atom is SP2 hybridized if it is trigonal pyramidal. Trigonal pyramidal molecules have usually one pi bond, and the rest will be sigma. Finally, an atom will be SP hybridized if it is linear in geometry and if it has two pi bonds. And so that can be either in the case of, for example, carbon, that would have a triple bond. That would be an example of that. Also, a carbon or a nitrogen or any atom that has two double bonds would be an example of something that is SP. So in both of these cases, these molecules are linear, and that's really the determining factor here. So if it's SP3, it's going to be tetrahedral usually. SP2, it's going to be trigonal pyramidal. If it's SP, it's going to be linear. Here's an example that contains all the situations we've talked about. Starting on the left, we see a carbon atom that is bonded to three other things. So it's bonded to a carbon atom, another carbon atom, and a hydrogen. So the geometry around that carbon atom, since it's bonded to three things, is going to be trigonal planar. So that is going to be an SP2 hybridized carbon. Actually, all of the carbons in this ring are going to be SP2 hybridized because they are all, if you notice, they are all bonded to three other things. The carbon atom out here, away from the ring, is bonded to four other atoms. It's bonded to two carbon atoms, and it's bonded to two hydrogen atoms. And so that one is going to be SP3 hybridized. The carbon next to it is going to have, again, three things around it. So it's got the carbon atom here, the carbon atom here, and then the oxygen atom. So this is a trigonal pyramidal geometry. And so this one is going to be SP2. The oxygen atom below it that it's double bonded to should have two pairs of electrons on it. So it is actually bonded to only one other atom, but it has two lone pairs of electrons. So it has three things around it. It is going to be trigonal planar as well. So this is going to be SP2 hybridized. All right, moving on, the carbon to the right of it is going to be bonded to only two other atoms. So it's bonded to a carbon with a triple bond and then another carbon with a single bond. So since that one has two pi bonds and two sigma bonds, we're going to call that SP hybridization. The carbon next to it is also SP hybridized. And if we wanted to categorize the hydrogen atom, we would say that it is unhybridized because hydrogen does not typically need to perform any type of hybridization. It doesn't have any electrons in p orbitals, and so hybridization with hydrogen atoms is not necessary.